Have you ever struggled with creating custom form controls in Angular? The boilerplate code, control value accessor interface. It's been pain points for years. Well, signal forms change everything. In this video, I'm going to show you what creating a custom form control looks like with new experimental signal forms in Angular 21 and how dramatically different and simple it is compared to template-driven and reactive forms. We will build a simple reaction picker component that seamlessly integrates into signal forms, keeping the selected value always in sync with a corresponding form control model, as well as other form control states like disabled and required. And as a little bonus, at the end of this video, I will share with you the future of Angular Forms and the Control Value Accessor. My name is Dmytro Mrzenski, and I create advanced Angular tutorials and courses helping developers around the world become advanced experts in this awesome framework. Now, let's iterate our knowledge and take a closer look at creating of custom form controls in brand new signal-based Angular Forms. For this tutorial, I prepared a simple signal-based form where users can leave feedback about anything. As of now, users can interact with only one form control, specifically the text area, that is successfully bound to the corresponding field in the form model. So, when the user types something into it, the value of the form control and the corresponding model stay in sync. Now, imagine that our goal is to extend our form and provide users with an option to express their reaction, something like a star rating but with emotions. Because this type of control doesn't exist among other built-in native form control primitives, we need to manually implement this picker component, which I actually created upfront in order to save your time. So, as you can see, the component appeared inside our form and it works fine, allowing us to choose any reaction from the list. However, the selected reaction is not synchronized with the corresponding control model inside our form. Obviously, this is because those two do not know anything about each other yet, and we need to bind them using the control directive as we did for the text area. So, let me try doing the same thing and see what happens. And unfortunately, once I save this change, happens a runtime error. This error happens because the control directive expects that the element this directive is attached to has certain properties that are common for other native form controls like inputs, text area, etc. And if you are already experienced Angular developer, you know that template-driven and reactive forms in Angular have a similar issue, and there the problem is solved by using control value accessor. The concept of control value accessor is a combination of a properly provided and configured ng value accessor injection token and control value accessor interface, implementation of which allows any component or directive to be used by Angular Forms as if it were a normal form control element. And by the way, I have covered this topic in my old but still relevant video. The hint and link to this video should appear somewhere there above. And also, even more in depth, I dive into this topic in my Advanced Angular Forms course. In the video description, I will leave the link to this course, so if you want to learn how to build scalable and complex forms and form controls with Angular, check it out. Anyway, in signal forms, this problem is much simpler to solve. Let me show you how. To make our custom component work with signal form controls, your component needs to implement a specific interface called FormValueControl. which is actually a generic type that allows you to define the type of the value that will eventually be used as a form control value. If you explore this new interface, you will see that it requires you to implement only one read-only property, not four methods like with control value accessor, just one property, and this property must be called value, and it needs to be a model input. So let's get back to our reaction picker component, and let me quickly bring this property to the component class. So I could introduce this value property somewhere inside the reaction picker class, but we already have a property called selected that serves this purpose. So what I will do is simply rename the selected property to value, and instead of using a simple signal, I will use the model input as required by the form value control interface. And obviously, because I renamed the property, I need to adjust it in multiple places in my component to align everything with this my change. Now, watch what will happen when I save this change. And you can see the runtime error disappears and my form is back. And now the user can select any emotion in the component, and the selected value, the selected emotion, will be synchronized with the corresponding form control model. This is precisely what I wanted to achieve. And of course, everything works in the opposite direction too. For example, if we go to app component and set some initial value for the reaction form control model, you can see that its initial value is synchronized with the value property in the rating picker component, and the state is reflected accordingly. So the value synchronization works perfectly. But what about other form control states? For example, what if we want to disable a control under a certain conditions? Let's say that before choosing a reaction, we need to provide at least one character in the feedback text. It means that now our reaction control model is actually disabled. However, our picker component doesn't visually reflect this form model state, which might be very confusing for users. So how we can synchronize this state? The good news is that with signal forms, it is pretty straightforward. So let's go back to the reaction picker component and investigate in depth the form value control interface that this component implements. As you can see, it extends the Form UI control interface, and this interface defines several other optional parts of the form control state that can be linked or synchronized with the model, similar to the value synchronization we did before. So if you scroll a little bit up, you can see that in order to synchronize the disabled state, according to this interface, I need to create a read-only property in my component class and call it disable. And it has to be a signal-based input, which might have some default value. Then I can use the value of this signal input to reflect the disabled state of my picker component. And very often it can be achieved by applying certain CSS classes or properties to maybe reduce opacity or doing stuff like that. So whenever the disabled signal value is true, the disabled state class will be added to the host element or removed otherwise. And let me save this change and notice how the disabled state is now properly reflected on UI. So you can visually see that the component is disabled and I cannot pick anything here. However, once I enter some review text, the picker is enabled again and I can interact with it. This synchronization happens fully automatically, so you don't have to do any other actions. Simply implement the corresponding property according to the form value control interface. Besides the simplicity that this new approach brings, It is also much more robust compared to ControlValueAccessor, which can synchronize only value, disabled state, and touch state. The form value control in signal forms goes far beyond. For example, if the UI of your custom control component depends on whether the control is required or not, this wouldn't be such a trivial task in template-driven and reactive forms, because it would require knowledge of some in-depth abstractions like ng-control and how to use them. With this new approach, it is as simple as handling the disabled state, because if you remember, the FormUI control interface also exposes properties like required. This means that I can simply duplicate the disabled property and then rename it to required. And then I can use this signal somewhere in the component template. So maybe here in the beginning, if the control is marked as required, I'm going to display some required marker. It's that simple. And if I save this change, you will not see any changes, obviously, because the reaction control has no required validator applied. However, once we apply the required validator to the reaction form control, then you can see that the required marker appears on the component UI, which is exactly what I needed. And again, you don't need to explicitly provide the required input and its value in the component template, because this synchronization happens automatically by signal forms. Now, think about what we just accomplished within these few minutes. We could create a fully fledged custom form control, the value of which is always in sync with a corresponding form control model. It respects disabled state, and its view can react on whether the required validator is applied or not to the corresponding form control model. It can be easily scaled, and other form control states like errors could be added to our custom form control with little amount of code and zero boilerplate. And now compare it to control value accessor with its much trickier API, where you have to implement four methods. It requires specific provider configuration. And the worst part is to synchronize certain state like touched and value, you have to call manually explicitly certain functions. This creates much higher chances of introducing bugs and wrong usage. The new signal forms eliminate most of these issues. And before I finish this video, there are a few notes that I would like to mention about this topic. The note number one is that besides the form value control interface, which we covered in this video, there is also an interface called form checkbox control. This interface should be implemented if your custom form control simulates checkbox behavior, so something like switcher, toggles, etc. The only difference in this interface is that it requires a check property to be implemented instead of value. The rest reminds actually the same. Secondly, I would like to answer the question if the controlled value accessor goes away. No, it doesn't. Although we don't have to deal with it in signal forms, it is still required piece for template-driven and reactive forms that are not going to be deprecated and will coexist with signal forms, which will eventually get some sort of interop for compatibility with older forms. And to achieve this compatibility, signal forms reference control value accessor under the hood. I learned this from Angular core team in one of the threads in my Angular Discord community, which you can join as well. It is free and open for everyone. And this is actually great news, because I don't have to re-record my best-selling course Advanced Angular Forms from scratch, because the knowledge base from that course remains relevant for long time. Whether you need to build a complex and custom form control like dropdown, or if you need a clean and flexible validation error management system, or if you need a scalable architecture for dynamic forms that are created from a JSON config. All these things are covered in the course and packed into well-structured lectures. Of course, once signal forms become stable, the course will be updated to the latest Angular version and extended with the new signal forms content. In the video description, you will find a link that also offers a little but very pleasant discount for the first 20 students. All right, maybe you have other questions about this topic. If so, please leave them in the comments under this video and I will try to answer all of them or at least the most liked ones. If you find this video useful, please, please, please share this video with your colleagues and friends. In such a way, you can also help my channel to grow. And if you particularly like what I'm doing, you can support the release of my next videos on Patreon or here in YouTube by joining the YouTube membership program. And thank you so much for everyone who already joined. Otherwise, I wish you a productive week ahead, guys. Stay safe and see you in the next video.